Happy morning, kiddos. Now we are going to see the rest of the lesson. Before that, let us have a quick recap of yesterday's lesson. Now, let's get into the lesson. Change in states of matter. Usually, matters change their state as the temperature changes. Solid changes into liquid as the temperature increases. Similarly, liquid changes into gas on heating. Whereas on cooling, gas becomes liquid and liquids become solids. Now, let us discuss this in detail. There are four processes, namely melting, freezing, evaporation and condensation. The first two processes deals with heating, whereas the rest two deals with cooling. First, let's see about melting. Ice cube, which is a solid, melts and changes to water, that is liquid. So, solid on heating changes to liquid. You can try this at home, children. Just take an ice cube and keep it outside. You can see the changes from solid to liquid after sometimes as the temperature increases. Now we are going to see about freezing. Here the temperature decreases. Change of liquid into solid on cooling is known as freezing. For example, we can take ice cubes. Take a ice tray and pour water in it and just keep it in the freezer. The water gets cooled and become ice, that is solid. You can try this too. And next comes evaporation. Here the liquid changes to vapor, that is gas on heating. The change of liquid to vapor on heating is called as evaporation. For example, we'll take water. If we boil the water, we can see the steam coming out of it. That is what called as evaporation. Here the liquid, that is the water, changes to gas on heating. And our last, condensation. Here the gas changes to liquid on cooling. For example, cloud on cooling condense and fall as rain. Let me make it more clear to you. Have you ever noticed the droplets in the lid of your lunchbox when you open it, children? It is because of condensation. Usually, your mom used to cook food and pack it very hot, right? So, the steam inside, it doesn't have space to escape, so it gets deposited in the lid of your lunchbox. So, when you open it during lunch, you can see the droplets in the lid of the lunchbox. That is, the steam changes to water on cooling. This is what we called as condensation. Now, we'll see about fuel. Children, what do you feel when you heat something? Yeah, we feel hot. Substance, when burnt, give out heat. But in some substance, the heat released is very low. So, they are not used for heating purpose. We use only the substance which gives out more heat. And they are called as fuels. Fuels got divided into three types. Namely, solid fuels, gaseous fuels and liquid fuels. And these are some examples of solid fuels, namely coal, charcoal, wood and cow dung. And these are some examples for gaseous fuel, gobar gas and LPG. And these are some examples for liquid fuels, kerosene, vegetable oil, petrol. Okay, children, we'll wind up this with three questions. Now, the first one. See the picture, children. There are two cans. One of these cans was in the fridge and the other was not. Children, find out which can was in the fridge. Yeah, the red one. Children, how do you find that? Yes, it's because of the water droplet that is present all over it. That denotes melting. Now the next question. See, there is a balance. I'm gonna keep an air-filled ball in one plate and an empty ball in the other plate. What will happen, children? The air-filled ball goes down. But why? It's because
air as mass, that is the weight. So it goes down. Now the last one. Have you seen the coconut oil? Yes. The coconut oil freezes during winter. What makes it to freeze, children? See, I'm not going to tell you the answer. You're going to find it and send voice message to your class teacher. Let's see how many of you are going to find it. Hope you guys enjoy this lesson. Thank you. See you in the next one.